What's up, stream? I'm gonna play some Madden today because of Super Bowl 55 today. Chiefs and the Bucks. Someone put me out because I'm on fire. I'm voting for the Chiefs to win, even though I have family members that want to go from Tampa. I think the Chiefs are going to pull it off. It's going to be a close game for sure, though. I don't care. Alright, we're just gonna do a play now game between the Chiefs and the Bucks. I think the Bucks are the home team, I think. I think they're playing in Tampa Bay, so I'm gonna go exhibition. Play now. There it is, look at that. Gonna go the Chiefs 14-2, Bucks went 11-5. I'm not sure if it's the full game or like just part of it or like just shortened quarters. I'm not quite sure. I think it's full quarters. Full 15-minute quarters. I don't know. I think I'm gonna win this game, to be honest. Yeah.
Tonight,
here it is.
The National Football League.
Let's watch this intro.
Super Bowl 55.
Between the Chiefs and the Bucks. And the Buccaneers. Let's go. I like the Bucks though. Don't get me wrong, I like the Bucks.
We'll see Tom Brady and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs.
Well, it's been 12 of the longest months ever since Super Bowl 54 took place downstate in Miami, and the world has certainly changed an awful lot in that time. But tonight, for a few hours, we bring the focus back to the greatest spectacle the sporting world has to offer. Super Bowl 55 from Raymond James Stadium in Tampa. And what a matchup we have in store.
Let me just send a message to the Discord real quick.
We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Kansas City Chiefs taking on the champions from the NFC, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Brandon Gaudin and Charles Davis on hand. And Charles, we know how difficult it is to go back-to-back in the NFL. Few have succeeded in doing so. But here are the Kansas City Chiefs, champions of the AFC yet again, try to lift that Lombardi Trophy.
Remember, this is a franchise that played in the first ever Super Bowl. Then they ended up winning Super Bowl IV, which was 50 years prior to winning Super Bowl 54. They didn't want to win another 50
years.
Yes,
sir.
So they went ahead and made it back this year. What a great run for this Kansas City team.
Meanwhile, the Buccaneers are back in the Super Bowl for just the second time in franchise history.
How is this?
One thing, they'd love a repeat of that first appearance.
Would they ever? That was 2003 in San Diego, and it was Super Bowl 37. They were the underdogs coming in against the Oakland Raiders, and they flogged the Raiders in that game, 48-21.
All right. You know what I remember most? I guess we're going to kick it off here.
John Gruden was the head coach of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, but he'd previously been the head coach of the Oakland Raiders. And during practice leading up to the game, he would play scout team quarterback and tell the defense all the characteristics and mannerisms of the Raiders quarterback Rich Gannon, and had his defense totally prepared. And boy,
I think it is.
And won their first Super Bowl title.
So out come the Bucks now for their first drive.
And 4-1 for
the man calling
that's really stacked numbers.
And what I enjoyed watching this week when we had a chance to watch them in practice, the easy camaraderie that he has with his offense.
A lot of respect,
and frankly, I thought it spilled over to the defense. All the defensive guys were coming over and teasing and joking with him. You can tell they respect the heck out of him and really want to play well for him.
Alright. And now we're in watch the stream for right now.
Brady now on first down.
It's not like I'm forcing it.
Looking for Godwin.
And already we picked it off.
Picked up by Charvarius.
And already the first point. That's a pick six. Oh my God.
What a moment for him. A pick six in the Super Bowl. You think about some of the big pick sixes over the history of this huge game. I remember because I was watching with a lot of Colts fans, Tracy Porter picking Peyton Manning to get the Saints' first title.
Yeah, that one pretty much sealed the deal for New Orleans as well. But I got to go back a ways because, you know, unfortunately, I'm considerably older. Herb Adderley, the Green Bay Packers, got it all started. The first pick six, Super Bowl II against the Oakland Raiders, and some of the better ones that were out there. You might remember Dwight Smith of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers had 2-1 game when they won their Super Bowl championship against Rich Gannon in Oakland. You mentioned Tracy Porter already. How about James Harrison and the Steelers? You remember that one? 100 yards right before the half ended. That was a big-time play. But for me, the absolute classic, Willie Brown in slow motion against the Vikings for the Raiders. The grand old man, Willie Brown, 75 yards.
You recall them all, and what a play here. Another pick six in the Super Bowl. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return.
Not looking
this
good for Tom Brady and the Bucs right touchback.
Now, this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10.
I already got a pick six, so, yeah. I think dogs all good.
Now Brady to try again after the pick six.
I wanted to do an audible. I think that's my time, too.
And they're able to get this one across the 35.
It's okay, still early.
He was a 1,000-yard receiver during the regular season, and that's his first catch of this Super Bowl, and he picks up the first down.
I think we're going to recover two here.
There's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man.
I mean,
he'll get a nice chunk there on the first down.
I guess 6 yards in there.
Second and four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
At the 41-yard line.
Now the toss to Jones, running right. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Throwing is Brady on third down. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him.
Oh, no, Godwin.
And he's going to have the Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His first catch of this Super Bowl, and it'll be good for a first down.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. From the gun, it's Brady.
What is he doing? Throw the ball away.
Frank Clark. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13.
Second and 23. Oh, my God.
Defensively, pressure coming off that right side from the DM.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle.
I don't know
maybe
why I didn't throw it away there.
To take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
It'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23.
Okay.
Another try after the first down sack. Brady quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. And Charles, despite this list of key inactives that we see here, they've obviously still been pretty successful.
Give everyone credit for this one, because to me, when that happens, key guys are out, the next man steps up and plays well, but that starts with the organization itself, all the way through. No excuses for guys being out, finding guys who are capable backups who can step up and play when they need them.
That's like the fourth and nine game, we'll gain up 11 on the play.
antenna.
Well, that's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
All right. Yeah, that's just bad play calling. At least they get the first down.
Now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will be out of bounds, and they spot it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad.
The KC offense
set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former
only
MVP.
Six interceptions, 38 TDs, 4,074 yards, 390 for 585
for an arm. That's and that's stacked. Not a surprise. He's the son of a former major league pitcher, so the bloodlines come into play. The biggest question for Patrick Mahomes, can he harness that big arm, develop the touch that's needed, and carry his team towards the playoffs?
They fake the give. Now Mahomes sliding out of the pocket. Now he'll pull it down. He's got first down past the 30.
Wow.
And all the way up to the
16-yard line.
A nice job there on the escape and scramble. First down, a 16-yard gain.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Look at that. A great rush by Mahomes there. We can do shotgun pass, probably bench exit.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Working from the gun, Mahomes. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And he'll have it.
What a catch by Tyreek Hill.
Before being taken down. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one that they're at the catch and we get guys on the ground. We can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Probably another PA.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 40.
All these are working so far. It's okay.
Throwing now is Mahomes. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And that is caught.
Oh, what a great catch without a bounce.
He was trying to get it to Tyreek Hill that time, but it'll be second down.
And that may have been incomplete, but he reminds me so much of what my dad used to take me to the baseball stadium and watch the home run hitters in batting practice. I'll get to the stadium early just to watch this kid throw it. He can throw it out of the stadium.
Rolling to his left.
Opening. Found an opening.
He's got the first down here inside the 30. And finally taken down at the 30-yard line. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier on this drive.
Yeah, and so now two times this has happened.
Move those chains,
something?
Baby.
Yeah, I think you do. I think you got something about your rush lanes. Try not to either get too wide or too narrow. Make sure someone is there waiting for him to take off.
Final 30 seconds of this first quarter, and it's been a quarter dominated by the guys with the football. Flushed out right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Jordan Whitehead there defensively.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now we had a guy who made the catch. They try to get the big one downfield. The
My God, I thought Kelsey
was added. It was linebacker Devin White there to knock it away. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions. Have him looking at third and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And it's complete.
Nice catch by Kelsey.
And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 13-yard line.
It's a gain of 17 yards.
Oh,
and a first down.
They stopped at 2 seconds. All right.
That's the end of the first quarter.
Right, so it's like, looks like a 6-minute quarter. So,
Sports.
Yeah. Might be a little bit of a shorter stream. just playing this one game and then I'm gonna hop off.
First and 10.
Because I'm gonna go watch the Real Super Bowl.
Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes.
And that's gonna be caught this time by Kelsey for the TD, the tight end. Let's go.
And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead.
For good reason, quarterbacks want to get the ball to the perimeter to their wide receivers for big plays. But in this situation, based on coverage, he knew that he wanted his tight end to have the football, and for good reason.
Butker on for the PAT.
Point here.
It's good to make it
14-0.
So
let's go.
Takes him down the field in eight plays.
Eight plays for 86 yards.
For the Kansas City touchdown.
Really good. Their defense is really really struggling to make plays that drive.
Harrison Butker to kick off for Kansas City.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away.
What a kick by Butker.
That'll be taken about a yard deep.
He's at the 20.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee. Maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
Back now comes Tampa Bay. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. That's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I'm actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
I like that move.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Wow.
This defense really fooled around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Yeah, they do. They're not doing too good.
The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. 53. Working from the gun, it's Brady. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski. Complete.
Oh my God.
He'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice play game. So far.
15 yards as Tampa Bay picks up the first.
I'm okay with four the call. In fact, I actually and like it. I know they're down yards. A couple of scores. But the running game
could
worked
be
in that situation,
though.
I would continue to go in that direction.
After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. Quick slant to Brown.
Nice catch by Antonio Brown. It's not the first down, but
nice.
Really nice game, though.
8 yard gain, second and 2.
Man. This ain't good.
Second and 2 at the 44-yard line.
Brady gives this one off to Jones.
Oh my God!
He'll take this close to a first
tackle?
Down at the Chiefs 38.
Boy, second and 2 is prime time for a little bit. Open up the playbook. Go play action. Toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Pass incomplete. I think that's roughing the passer. Backfield. This might be a roughing call. Well, they'll get the yardage, but they hate to see him take that hit.
You're always trying to cool off a big time.
I don't think it was that big of a hit, to be honest.
But you have to know when to back off, pull up, and not hit it. There's the penalty.
I want to look at the replay, but
Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. again. Brady. And now a fumble.
Oh, fumble. Recovered by.
Able to fall on it, but look where they were
covered by the offense. But
a lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but that outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
He is not happy. Covered by Jensen.
So possession still there, but now they face a third down.
Let's see.
Operating from the gun, Brady. This into the hands of
his running back. Oh, come on. What are we doing?
And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there.
Well, offensively, right, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out in some open space. The
if they go for
nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Not good. Not good blocking for this. So just do this.
And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe.
There it is.
Get themselves on the board here at 14-3.
All right, 14-3. Test team below.
Well, that's something of a pick me up for the offense. Certainly has struggled, but they do get the field goal before half to put three on the board.
Yeah, you don't want to be shut out, but let's face it, those 3 points, that's not going to solve all their problems either.
Start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
All right. Good rush. 34 yards.
Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at the 31-yard line.
He'll notice how we're going to go Hail Mary.
Flush to his right. Oh, he'll try run it. And they get him down, but not before he takes across the 40-yard line.
Too many warnings.
1:58 left to we hit halftime.
Alrighty, I like it.
Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Eluding the pressure right. And he's going to keep it here. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Good coverage downfield led to him taking picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On play action, it's Mahomes out to his left. He's going to take off with it. Oh, what a juke into space.
Whoa.
And he gets it inside the 35.
Jesus, Patrick Mahomes.
Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now they'll throw with Mahomes. He'll buy some time right. That one complete to Hill. And he is out of bounds.
I thought I was going to run it.
Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
They talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up the first down.
I'm going to go a little run play here. He should be tossed
so
to right.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10.
Oh, my God. What a juke.
From the 10 to the 5 tackle on a pickup of 5.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great
leverage. Oh, God, I didn't even notice him walking.
To turn to the side.
Oh, my God.
Receiver, the ball carrier. And
The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Kelce out in the slot right. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Chiefs are able to extend their lead.
That score that they just gave up there, that's a tough one for their defense to swallow
score
because they had a tough time through the first two quarters.
20,
they really were determined to get a stop
21-3.
There. Unable to do so, that makes their comeback hopes that much more difficult.
Tucker now to add the extra point.
That's got to be 21-3. Nice.
And it's 21-3. So that drives seven plays in length. And it ends with a Le'Veon Bell touchdown run.
Oh, Le'Veon Bell with TD. Okay.
Harrison
like
Bunker
it.
To kick off for
like
Kansas City.
Now after the touchdown, here's Bunker on to kick it away.
Let's go. Nice kick.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
At their own 20-yard line.
And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But there's also something to challenging your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole? See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard at the 29-yard line.
The final shot before half for Brady.
Okay.
A quick pass here to Godwin.
I guess.
And he'll be brought
down. I get ball back, so.
At the 38-yard line.
So
we've reached halftime here in Super Bowl 55. As we toss it
right,
an hour
y'all.
East
half
of
time.
Here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a
here's
season this has been. Hard to believe it
here.
Ends tonight. As we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment. Thus far, this Super Bowl has looked less like a contest and more like a coronation. And to call the second half, let's get it right back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams ready after the halftime spectacle.
All right, let's go. We're going to
we are back underway.
Gonna do this, baby.
Shut
up, Milo.
Taken in at the 3. The lane opens here. He's past the
30. Oh, we are gone.
At the 50. Still going inside the 30. And they are not going to catch him. He's in.
Out of 97-yard touchdown return.
Talk about taking words and bringing them to life.
What a run.
I will guarantee you in their locker room, they talked about pressing the kicking game because you can get an advantage if you do it right, and they just did.
97 kickers. God, Milo, shut up. Shut up, bro.
Butker on for the PAT.
All right, that makes it 28-3.
That's 25 points. Quite a bit of razzle-dazzle electricity on that return. It goes for 97 yards.
Shut up, Milo!
So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff.
Oh! The Bucks take over first and 10 the at their own 25-yard line.
Did you hear that, Stream? Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that.
Can
one
you please
guy
shut up, Milo?
Who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmate. Probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
Here's a throw caught by Gronkowski.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
To throw on third down, Brady.
What is he doing? He lost, like, what?
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big.
What were you doing, Brady?
In a big way, don't you?
They just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche that's coming right on top of us. The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away.
They only had a field goal, and that's basically it.
Hardman on the return.
No, again.
And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And it's Chiefs football. First and 10. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have them in the rearview mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives that end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball to create that distance, and they're on a really big time.
Oh, Tyreek Hill! There he goes, right side! The fastest player in the league!
And all the TD! Kansas City touchdown!
This is just unbelievable. 51 yards.
And the Chiefs have got
what a play by Mahomes.
So that's going to be a nice one for the passing stats. So that's how it will go down in the stat sheet. But the success of that play, no
doubt,
all thanks to the talents of the wideout.
He was definitely.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And this fake extra point attempt failed big time. Not only did they not get it, they went backwards.
34-3.
I know they're not asking me, but I'll give you my opinion anyway. I think it's time to erase that play from the call sheet. I guess they figure with the big lead, they can experiment a little bit. But all in all, just go ahead and put that play on ice.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away.
What a kick by Butker.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drive you deserve to come off the field.
31-yard line.
Not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try to figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
It's a gain of
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
At the 30.
I'm really just picking random plays at this point.
From the gun, Brady. And now a fumble. Brady loses.
Oh, my God, a fumble? And he couldn't get back up. Another one!
And it's picked up by the Chiefs. Going down the left side. It's a foot race.
Oh my God, that has to be the worst play I've ever seen.
Back. A fumble recovery for a Chiefs touchdown.
In the NFL history, that's just unbelievable.
And what we just saw, very rare.
He
only had 5 of those.
Tom Brady fumbled
12,
like 2 separate times.
The biggest stage, the biggest game, and we just saw it happen again. Extraordinary.
The defense has been good, and they were good again there. Butker now to add the extra point.
And now two turnovers.
And he pushed it.
And
right.
Butker
it's
misses
no
the extra point. Oh man. I guess it doesn't really matter. It's like 40 or 30.
Harrison Butker to kick off for Kansas City.
All right, we're a sky kick here.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score.
taken in at the three. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And that last possession, really a gut punch. You seemingly had it working. You were in the midst of a very strong drive.
It's a gun,
and suddenly
it's a gun
fumble,
punch for the
watching the back of a defender's jersey as he brings it all the way in the other direction.
Clark right now. They're
just
I thought
you
summarized
it perfectly, partner. You just got to regroup and start putting another drive.
Shut up, Milo.
That's all you can do.
25-yard line.
Looking to throw again on second down. Brady. And that'll be it.
That's happening.
We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about.
Another roughing the passer penalty, this time on Chris Jones.
I think you'd agree that looked like the right call from up here.
No doubt about it. What everyone has to understand is that the officials are going
injured
to be right on the play each and every time. You may not like
happened
the call,
we'll
but
check
usually
after the game.
Spot on.
So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after
roughing
the passer.
I might check out
after
for sure.
After the penalty, it's Jones. He'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 14 yards there and a Buccaneer first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just
going
to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
We're going to go blitz here.
Plays. Have him on the move on first down. Brady's throw complete.
Oh,
for
wow.
And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before
man,
he takes
actually
it inside
doing
the
something
40. They get
holy
10 more
cow
there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Somehow Brady's only has, only has like, what,
36 yard line.
That was the very first play of the game.
Now Jones. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 12 more yards there and another first down.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here.
This is just
easy
right now.
Three first downs.
Easy.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And this
uh-oh
time they were
that's
ready
not
for
good
it as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Credit to tackle to Tano Passanio. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Looking to throw on second down. Brady. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well. And that one's incomplete.
Milo. Please.
Under pressure
Milo.
And down he goes. They sack him back at the
36. That's the fourth time Brady's done that. Just freaking throw the
this
ball.
Time a sack.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. Five sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
3 yards. And this is off to
he completely
left.
Didn't
get there
the
anyway.
Goal.
It's no good, and this score will stay right where it is.
NFL kickers nowadays, they make things look so easy because normally from this range, about 2 out of 3. And this is not an easy kick.
Yeah, 20 years ago, you get where he was, and he's going to be taken
oh, no
down. They sack him on what will be the final play of quarter number 3. 1 quarter remains
19 points
here
in the
Super Bowl.
The third quarter.
This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15.
Oh.
Call it 7 yards on the carry, so a pretty good game, but still left with a tough third and 8.
Points allowed, season right 4. This game, 40.
Third down.
Oh, my God. That's horrible. That's just horrible. Tampa Bay, only 61 yards. That's atrocious.
Escaping the pressure right. He may try and run for this. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Able to make something out of nothing there.
I tried to do a back juke.
17 yards and a first down.
Now that definitely hurts because the mindset is getting a three and out there.
Milo,
they don't get it done.
Please,
they
be
give
quiet.
Up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
Jesus. Stupid dog.
So here's a first and all 10 at the 30.
Not sure he has to go.
Mahomes now to throw. Flushed out right. He'll run it. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear.
Out, Earth.
Nah,
Milo.
Dead to rights,
please,
you are
be
exactly
quiet.
Correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive game. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete.
Yeah, he's knocked over the camera.
Good effort there, trying to take
see
a
that?
Shot, but it's third down.
Holy
the
cow.
Chiefs on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and four. They go play action. Now Mahomes steps away. Pressure applied.
Oh, no.
Taken down. They sack him
oh,
back
no.
at the 33-yard line. Jason Pierre-Paul able to get outside the numbers and drop
Jason
him for
Pierre-Paul
a loss of a yard.
Giant.
And hear the pressure from the outside linebacking spot.
And normally when that happens and they're able to get home, that means the other guys on his team helped him out a lot. That they occupy right. people.
50
to
yards
to be
vehicle.
No less than a one-on-one situation allows him to get home.
A 50-yard attempt.
Oh, this is a
That's
horrible kick.
That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short.
Oh,
no
so
good.
Close.
And this score will stay close. Right where it is.
Buccaneers, three.
Well, they can probably live with that
pretty
one.
Close.
It's like leading the fourth quarter. That's one of the few things that's gone wrong.
You're exactly right. This one was well in hand. That kick there is more for cosmetics.
It's
you
almost
know,
over.
Their score, not getting it, that shouldn't harm them at all.
First and 10. Here's Brady. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
It's good. Unless it
intended for Mike Evans.
Tampa Bay can
brings up second and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Today 11. That's just
Brady's
so,
incompletion
that's
on first
horrible.
Down leads to a second and 10.
That's just horrible. Unbelievable.
To throw again. Brady. And this is
incomplete.
No! Sean Breland there defensively and able to knock that one down to the ground.
So offense.
Incomplete.
Yours
brings up a third down and 10 yards to go.
The Bucs on third down. They've converted just 2-for-6 thus far. This is third and 10. Now Brady. Going for Evans.
And another pick.
Picked off by Rashawn Breland. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. The utter domination here just continues. This defense, I don't know what
a
more we can say all around about their performance.
Well, Tyreek Hill
feels in this game like maybe they're facing a Canadian defense. 12 guys on the field. It feels like there's an extra on every
who scores
snap
touchdowns?
Because they have really
touchdowns.
Struggled to make headway through the air.
Kelce, Le'Veon Bell. I think our kick returner. Tyreek Hill. I think someone else scored, too.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And they are trying to play it cool down on the sidelines, but they know that they are very close now to wrapping this thing up and letting the celebration begin. A Super Bowl title within reach now as they try to polish this thing off. A gain of 6 there on first.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we can talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call
no way.
The cheese.
No way. No way, Mom.
It's hard to do. When you see a guy cutting that in that direction,
you tend
to go
to 111
yards. Help out downfield, but
that's
no problem.
That's very
rare.
Not only another first down, that also puts him over 100 yards rushing.
All right, that's not something you see very often in the NFL. We see it more in college. But I think with more of the melding of the college game with quarterbacks, we'll see this a little bit more often in the future.
And a scary almost picked off. INT of the game. Instead, second down.
Oh my god. Almost got picked off.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And now he's going to use his legs. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Give him time escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up the first down.
First down for Mahomes. Let's go.
All right. Super Bowl 55 down to the final 2 minutes.
Minute warning, score is 40-3.
So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10. Now he'll pull it down. Shedding the tackle.
Oh my God, is Mahomes going to score a TD?
And he will be brought down at about the 6 yard line. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16 yard gain.
All right, we'll see.
Now Mahomes on the bootleg. That is caught at the 7
and a TD.
And he will get into the end zone.
Another
touchdown. This thing is ugly. They seemingly just continue to score at will. And as great as it's been for the offense, you got a feel for that defense down there.
And I love how you use the word will, because both teams came into the game with the will to win. But one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them. Because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters.
His first TD of the game.
Butker on for the PAT.
All right, here we go.
Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So the drive there took 6 plays, and it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt.
Harrison Butker to kick off for Kansas City.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Taking it about the 1. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Those Super Bowl hopes that they had really dwindling now here in the fourth quarter. That NFC crown that they got 2 weeks ago seems like a distant memory, as they have been outplayed tonight. The intended target was Chris Godwin. That'll bring up second down.
Brings up second and 10.
Throwing again, Brady. He's got his big tight end, Gronkowski. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 5 yards, now it's 3rd and 5. The last play on the completion got him half of what they needed. Now here's a tough 3rd and 5. From the gun, it's Brady. And Jones has it over the middle. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down by about a yard as they find a way to convert there on 3rd down and 5.
But they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Game 6 there on first. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him, and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
Got his man complete over the middle. That's Jones. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Again, they'll throw with Brady. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 14 yards there and a Buccaneer first down.
You know what? We're going to do this. We're going to do this.
So from the 39 now,
we're going to do this.
First and 10.
They have no idea what's coming down their pipeline.
Again, it's Brady. Oh. That is taken down. A Chiefs sack.
They have no idea what score is coming down.
We'll do it again here.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long.
And game over.
Second and a bundle.
And the Chiefs are the Super Bowl champions.
And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them, a fantastic season.
I don't care about the highlights. Wow, 47-3. All right, I think that'll end the stream there. I just say on this, just this one game, and then I'm gonna hop off. Nah, just turn the main menu. But yeah, I hope y'all really enjoy the stream. I'm gonna post this later on YouTube. And I'm probably gonna take a little break from Twitch, and probably from live streaming in general. I'm not quite sure yet, but yeah, so thank you for watching the stream, and I'll see you next time I stream.